I could summarize IR-4 for the non-farming community, it's a incredible collaboration of government, university, industry, and producers, all working together with the goal of ensuring high quality, safe, and abundant specialty crops being produced in the United States.
IR-4 is really important because not only are you creating an avenue for us to get registrations for better, effective, safer, more environmentally friendly synthetic products that are maybe developed in field crops and on some of these large acreage crops and bring them into specialty crop agriculture, but also IR-4 has programs that are dedicated to also look at biological compounds that maybe you will use more for organic agriculture.
IR-4 is absolutely critical to make sure we get all of our fresh fruits and vegetables on the table and in the supermarket.
If IR-4 didn't exist, a lot of those needs in vegetable crops would go uncovered, and then that would mean that we would have losses in the vegetable crop industry. Some farmers may decide to stop farming vegetables, which would be really bad because vegetable crops are really important for nutrition. You know, they have vitamins, they have antioxidants, they're delicious. So I think IR-4 does a really good job helping us make sure that our vegetable farmers stay farming.
IR-4 not only provides the growers of specialty crops legal access to safe and effective pest management technologies, we serve them as an advocacy in the federal government. So for example, as EPA may be changing a policy on a particular way they regulate technology, or USDA may be looking for information, we serve as a facilitator to get this information from the commodity groups and help submit it to the respective government organizations to help them grow better crops and at a lower price to feed the population.
EPA has a very complicated but appropriate list of criteria and years of data that need to be collected before the EPA can consider approving a compound on a minor crop. So to go through those processes takes big science, takes field science and laboratory science.
IR-4 has a very unique structure. So we are connected with the land-grant university system throughout the United States. We have 4 regional laboratories and regional research offices. These offices and labs provide really a lot of the backbone of IR-4's research network. We've cooperated with Michigan State University Center for Economic Analysis, and we've asked them to do an assessment of what's IR-4's value to the public. And they came back that IR-4 contributes $8.7 billion on an annual basis to the gross domestic product and supports over 123,000 jobs.
IR-4 is celebrating its 60th year of being in existence. That's pretty amazing. It's an institution. As long as we have regulation and we have minor crops, we will need IR-4.
I think that the reason that IR-4 has been around for so long is that it has accomplished what it said it was going to accomplish. Identify the needs of producers, work with the industry to solve problems and to get that technology out to the user community, and then to be able to show the impacts of that. And I think as long as IR-4 continues to be impactful and to also to use all of the dollars that have been entrusted to it wisely, I don't see any reason why we won't be having this conversation in another 60 years.